went away on vacation. Third day into the vacation, we got a phone call from one of my kids telling me my son David wasn't feeling well, felt aches and pains. And at that point, I asked my brother, I said, you know what? I don't know what's wrong with him. Just in case, take him to Maimonides and we'll see what's wrong with him. They said, it's nothing, it's probably just a virus. He has the flu. Let him go home, have some soup and rest. Called him in the morning. He was sleeping. Kid said, he's fine, he's resting. We got him soup, he'll be okay. We got a phone call around 4 o'clock that afternoon from my son again, telling me, there's something wrong. David is not right. This is when I got a little bit worried. I asked my sister to then take my son to NYU. They told us, unfortunately, our son was in a coma. Bikur Holim called us, if I'm not mistaken, I think day four, asking us how they could help. I was quick to tell him, no thanks. I didn't need any food, which is what I thought Bikur Holim does, and I didn't need anybody to come visit. I had a lot of people coming to visit, so I didn't need him. Financially fine, I had a thriving business, more than 60 employees, insurance I had, everything I had. So I didn't need Bikur Holim's help, but I appreciated it. And as time went, things got a lot worse. This was a very tough time for us. Bikur Holim keeps reaching out week after week, trying. They probably called me at the worst times. I was nice to them sometimes, but I certainly wasn't at other times. And I feel terrible for whoever had the job, because they kept trying to call and ask me, you know, let me try to help you with this. Let me at least try to help you even with the doctors. And I said, okay. Well, I gave her the name of the doctor. She says, you have that doctor? I said, yes. She said, okay, so I don't need to give you a different referral, but I want to help you with anything else. Can I help you with a place to stay? Can I help you? But there was nothing that I needed at the time from Bikur Holim. Rabbis got involved because things got really dark and it was really a bad time. The rabbis asked us to change his name from David ben Miriam to David Chaim ben Miriam. 63 days into it, my wife has a dream. She wakes up super early, runs to the hospital, and says, David's gonna wake up today. And we go to the hospital and we see a flutter of an eye. His eye opened. David had a serious TBI, which is a traumatic brain injury. They tried to explain to us that the injury may not allow him to be the person that he was. 110 days finish. The insurance tells us that they're no longer going to pay for the ICU, but they're willing to take him into an acute care facility, which is RUSC. It's a rehabilitation center. And his doctors really did believe that he would defy the odds and he would be able to walk and talk again. Russ kept him there for almost 4 months. The insurance company only approved 2 months. So I had to spend a lot of money to keep my son, to give him the therapy. I had a great business. I had a lot of employees. I had money in the bank. I had goods on the shelf. I had a pending deal with Amazon that I couldn't go to the work and close because my kid was sick. And I had to put my priorities first. And it was very difficult time for me. But what we did is I finally reached out to Bikur Holim. They were very helpful. They knew the whole system. They knew exactly when my insurance company was gonna give up. They knew a lot. It was a wealth of information. And instead of just sitting there and just taking the punches, now I was able to move a little bit. Duck came to the office, bruised and battered, humbled and broken from a war that just took me apart. I came here, I had a tear in my eye, but Bikur Holim said, we need to help you. And I said, well, that's what I'm here for. And without going into too many details, Bikur Holim came through for me at a time where nobody else could come through. 8 months of fallout, I tried to rehash the deal with Amazon. It was done. I tried to see how much merchandise I had or how much money we went through, which was amazing. Not normal, the amount of money that we went through. But it wasn't just the money. Bikur Halim didn't come through with the money. They gave me my sanity. Today, thankfully, my son does everything on his own. And he's very motivated, and he gives us a lot of happiness every day. You know, we're just very thankful to Bikur Halim. You really came through in the clutch. I pushed you away, and thank God you didn't take it the wrong way. I feel terrible for the poor lady that had to call me week after week. I think they changed the lady every so often because of me. Bikur Halim is an opportunity for you all to give back. It's not just something where they just pay a bill, pay a utility bill, or pay your back rent and fix you up. This is something that, you know, it's kind of like that story where they tell you, you feed a guy a fish, he eats for a day. You teach a guy to fish, and he eats for a lifetime. It's a touching story, and it has a happy ending. The happiness is that we have our son, and we're thankful, and he's not in a facility, and he's able to make it because people believed in him. And we thank Bikur Halim for that.